Namaskara. Welcome to lecture number 2 of 18MAT 41, fifth module. I am Professor Ampiyoli, Professor of Mathematics, Optane Shop Technology, Belagami. Last time we introduced in lecture number 1 sampling theory and some examples on large samples. And today we shall continue with large samples. So I'll be starting with some one more next example. Hope we'll do first big sample examples, then we'll be coming to the small sample examples, that is samples of size less than 30. So here we start with next examples. These are my details. We are dealing with sampling and testing of a hypothesis. We have begun last time. Now I'll be continuing with the next examples. Here we had come up to example number 6. We have to start. Example number 6, again I am reminding you, these are for large samples, samples of size more than 30, samples of size 60, 1000, 1200, and we are converting into standard normal variate in terms of Z. And we are concluding using the standard normal variate tables for 95% confidence limits. We are taking minus 1.96 to plus 1.96. For 99% confidence, we are taking minus 2.58 to plus 2.58. So here, dear students, our focus is on whenever such examples are given for the sample, what is the mean, what is the standard deviation, what is the sample size, and how to convert it to Z. What is the hypothesis we are asked? That much we should consider. Once again, what is the mean? What is the standard deviation? Sample size. Three things: mean, standard deviation, sample size. Then how to frame the hypothesis or how to find the confidence limits. Here I am reading for you. The mean and standard deviation of the maximum loads supported by 60 cables are 11.09 and 0.73 tons. So a company is manufacturing some cable wires. So cable wires, maximum loads they can take in terms of tons, on an average 11.09 with plus or minus 0.73. So this 0.73 is variation in terms of standard deviation. So we have taken a sample of 60 cables in a lot of some thousands of cables. So this is a sample. Now, with what confidence we can tell that this belongs to the same population? What should be the limits for 95% confidence? What should be the limits for 99% confidence? So, question is, find the 95% or 99% confidence limits for this mean of the maximum loads of the cable produced by the company. So, while doing again solution, I'll explain it better now. See, sample size 60 cables, mean 11.09, mean of the sample. So sigma 0.73, this should be tons actually. Then for 95% confidence limits, we are always taking this part, x bar minus and x bar plus, 1.96 sigma by root n, 1 plus 1.96 sigma by root n. Here you are subtracting, here you are adding to x bar. So when I substitute all these x bar and x bar 11.09, sigma and sigma 0.73, sample size n and n 60, I am going to get two real numbers left hand side, right hand side, which is 10.91 to 11.27. So that if the mean of any sample, if the mean of any sample selected, sample of 60 now is selected, is between 10.91 to 11.27, we have 95% confidence that this sample belongs to the production of cables with that specification of it can carry this much of tons, that is how much tons this can carry on an average 11.09 tons. So what is that? If on an average, with what is the flexibility we can have? That flexibility I can give confidence 10.91 to 11.27. Now think of the guarantee card and warranty card the company is produced. Suppose you are in a position where your company main boss asks you, how much guarantee we can give? If you are more confident, you can give more guarantee. 95% confident, 5 years guarantee. 99% confident, you can give 10 years guarantee. So that if the bearing load is between 10.91 to 11.27, we are 95% confidence. Similarly, instead of 1.96 and 1.96, if you replace it by 2.58, naturally, the confidence interval should be bigger. If the confidence interval is bigger than this, so it should be smaller here, it should be bigger here. Then if you substitute this and calculate 10.85 to 11.33, this interval is bigger than this interval. So we are more confident. How much confident? 99% confident. Once again, you see, the mean, there is a 60 cable sample from a factory we have taken, where it is said that that sample has got 11.09 bearing capacity, that is 11.09 tons of loads it can withhold, with the plus or minus 0.73 variation. Standard deviation is spot plus or minus 0.73. What are the 95% and 99% confidence limits? What is the range for this, they are asking. What you did, sample size, mean, standard deviation in terms of tons it should be, then you are putting this formula, 1.96 for 95% confidence limits, 2.58 for 99% confidence limits. Here you are going to get these limits. In these limits, if the sample mean falls, then we are 95% confident. In this mean, if at all we want, then 99% confident. Smaller the range, lesser the confidence. So then go to the next example, where we have finished all small samples. If the big sample examples, if the sample size is smaller, then we have got what is known as t-distribution test. I am going to read for you. Instead, the last one is using Z platform. We can call it as Z transform, Z distribution test, but the official we don't call like that. Here we officially call student's t-distribution test. Student is the name of mathematician. This t-distribution is used when sample size is small, less than or equal to 30. And the questions are very similar, but the sample size is small and the population standard deviation is unknown. This is, we call it as t-statistic, is defined as same like earlier one, x bar minus mu by sigma by root n, where x bar is the mean, mu is the population mean. So here sample mean is also known, population mean is also known, and sigma is SD is the population standard deviation. Once again, sample mean, population standard deviation, sample size. Suppose if the standard deviation of sample is T, if statistic is, if sigma is not known, suppose population standard deviation is not known, then we are going to have, we calculate the standard deviation of the sample, which is S, and we find instead of this sigma by root n, we replace it by S by root of n minus 1, provided sigma is not known. So here we call it as n minus 1 degrees of freedom for n sample of size n. If S is not given, then in a usual statistic in 11th, 10th, 9th standard statistics, so we find standard deviation, summation of x minus x bar whole square by n minus 1, and again substitute that S in the formula. If the standard deviation is S is not given, then it is S by root n. If S is given, we find S by root of n minus 1. Now, we compare this calculated value of T with the standard values of table, just like which table I am showing you in the first example. And if this calculated value of T is less than the table value, we accept the hypothesis at alpha degrees of confidence. Otherwise, we reject the hypothesis. All these will understand if we start taking some examples. Similarly, difference of means, we have got this formula. If two samples are there, then we give this statistic. Suppose first sample is of size n1, second sample is of size n2. First sample average x1 bar, second sample average x2 bar. Then common standard deviation sigma will be found. With n1 plus n2 minus 2 degrees of freedom, we find. If s1, s2 are sample standard deviation, then instead of this formula, we use for sigma a common sigma, n1 s1 square plus n2 s2 square by n1 plus n2 minus 2. So these are from statistics. So this S is calculated using bivariate standard deviation formula. So during example, again I will be explaining you how we are going to find this bivariate standard deviation. Suppose you concentrate here. Suppose the life of electrical bulbs for a random sample of 10 from a large consignment is given by the following table. Can we accept the hypothesis? Already hypothesis is given that average lifetime of the bulb is 4000 hours. That means what? In a company, there are lakhs of bulbs manufactured. And they claim that on an average, bulbs burn for 4000 hours. So they have taken a sample of 10 bulbs. So if they have taken a sample of 10 bulbs, the sample size is small. Hypothesis is whether the bulbs burn 4000 hours or not. On this, we have to frame the sample. Now, sample size 10, and these are the bulbs given in terms of 1000 hours. This is in terms of 1000 hours. 4200 hours, you multiply by 1000, 4600, 3900 up to 5600. So all these, each bulb, first bulb, second bulb, 10th bulb, how many hours it is burning, it is given. The average we have to find using add divide by 10. So let us see how we solve it. First, we frame null hypothesis. There is no significant difference between sample and population mean. That means we agree that 4000 hours itself, here we are talking in terms of 1000, that's why I have made 4.00, so that 4000 hours itself is the population mean. We agree for it. Hypothesis is there is no difference between sample and population mean. 4000 hours is the sample mean. Now t statistic, t equal to x bar minus mu by sigma by root n. Now mu we know already, which is 4000 hours. In terms of 1000, I am talking 4 means 4000. X bar means I have to add all this, this plus, so on, this divide by 10, that I am going to get it as 4.4. S means summation of x minus x bar whole square divided by 10 minus 1. What is x minus x bar whole square? We know 4.4 is x bar. So 4.2 minus 4.4 whole square plus 4.6 minus 4.4 whole square. Similarly, every number you are subtracting 4.4, squaring it. That is, here every item minus 4.4 whole square, and add all those divided by n minus 1. So you are going to get 0.59 as s. So using this, we find this as x bar minus mu divided by s upon square root of 10. We substitute here. So this t statistic, we are going to get t calculated value as 2.123. Here there is a need that we compare this number with 2.26. And what is this number? For 95% confidence limits. That is, we are asked to find whether we accept it or not. For 95% confidence limits, we are testing it. How I get this number? Let us see. Now I have to go to this number. For 9 degrees of freedom, this is degrees of freedom. You go 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 up to 9. For 95 degrees of freedom means 0.05 level of confidence limits. So this used to come down, and this 9 you go straight. Here you are going to get 2.26. So 9 and here 2.26. Can you see this? 2.26. This we take here, and this calculated value is less than t table value for 9 degrees of freedom. Because why 9 degrees of freedom? Because whenever there are 10 values known, and when we know the addition of all those, answer also we know some of these numbers. So if you remove one number also, I can tell that. Suppose out of 10 values, if I know the sum of all the values, like 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6. So I tell that 1 plus 2 plus x is 6, that x should be 3. So when I know 10 numbers and the total, then one of the numbers need not be known. That's why degree is 9. So 10 minus 1 is 9 degrees of freedom. So now t calculated is less than t table value. We accept the hypothesis that average life of the bulb is 4000 hours. Similarly, suppose I take two groups now. A group of boys and girls were given intelligence test. So here mean score and standard deviation score and numbers in each group is as follows. So what is that? Boys and girls, mean intelligence, x1 bar, x2 bar, standard deviation, sigma 1, sigma 2, sample size, n1, n2. What is asked? Test the hypothesis that there is no significant difference between the intelligence of boys and girls. This statement we have to test using the t-distribution because sample sizes are less than 30. Now how we go about it? First we note down first sample size 12, 74, 8. Like this we note down 12, 74, 8. Sample size, mean, standard deviation of the sample. Similarly second one 10, 70, 10. Sample size, average, standard deviation. How to frame the hypothesis? There is no much difference between the intelligence of the girls and boys. In terms of sentences also you should write, there is no significant difference. Significant you can write, significant difference between the intelligence of boys group and girls group. So now we find a common sigma using these S1, S2. So put the values of S1, S2 here as 8 and 10, 8 square and 10 square, N1, N2 as 12 and 10, N1 plus N2, 12 plus 10 minus 2, 9.4. Using x1 bar, x2 bar and this sigma and N1 plus N2, like this we frame t statistic. When there are two samples, how to find t? X1 bar minus x2 bar, common sigma we have found into square root of 1 by N1 plus 1 by N2. So this, when you substitute all these values, you are going to get some real number. This real number, how you get this 20 degrees of freedom? Here you have to add these two, minus 2, because here also 12 minus 1 degrees of freedom. Here minus 1 means 10 minus 1. 12 minus 1, 10 minus 1. Totally 12 plus 10 minus 2. So this should be the degrees of freedom. So for 20 degrees of freedom, we have to find table value. So how we get this 95% confidence, 2.086 for 20 degrees of freedom. So let us see once again. For 20 degrees of freedom, for 0.5 means 0.5 level of significance means 95% confidence. So you come vertically 20 here. So 2.09, or here it is taken as 2.086 or 2.09. So this is t calculated is smaller than t table value. That time we again accept whatever we have thought. So there is no much difference between the intelligence of boys and girls. What we conclude? Accepted the hypothesis that there is no significant difference between the intelligence of boys group and girls group. For example, suppose because of the changed data, I get here 3.16. Then 3.16 will be greater than 2.086. At 95% confidence, that time I'll reject. That is what I'm telling. Suppose I get 3.1 suppose, instead of 0.94, then that time this will be greater than this. That time we have to, instead of accepting, we have to reject the hypothesis and tell that there is some difference between the intelligence of boys and intelligence of girls. So now we'll go to the next example. Two samples of sodium vapor bulbs were tested for length of life, that is duration of life, and the following results were got. Is the difference in the means is significant? To generalize that, type 1 is superior to type 2. Suppose somebody asks you, giving the two companies, which company is better, whether this company is superior to this company, that of example we are doing. So that here, type 1, N1, sample size 8, mean x1 bar, on and average 1234 hours they are burning, or what are burning? Vapor bulbs, sodium vapor bulbs, and on and average 36 hours standard deviation means 1234 plus or minus 36 hours is the range. Company 2 is size N2 7, x2 bar 1036 hours. Company 2 bulbs are on and average burning for 1036 standard deviation 40 hours. See, looking at that, you may be telling that this average is better than this average, but sample sizes are different, standard deviations are different. So suddenly we cannot come to the conclusion. So hence, how we test it? We note down this. We first frame the hypothesis. Both the companies are same. Means you can even you can write a sentence. Type 1 is not superior to type 2. How the hypothesis, null hypothesis is formed? In our mind, we feel that they are superior. They are not superior. So whatever is in our mind, we have to reject. We have to nullify that hypothesis. What is in our mind? Both the companies are same. But to reject that hypothesis, what I frame? Both the companies are not same. Type 1 is not superior to type 2. Both the companies are same here in our mind. So that alternative hypothesis is opposite of that. So now I note down whatever is given, x1 bar s1 n1, x2 bar s2 n2 according to the previous slide table. And we find the common sigma, which is n1 s1 square n2 s2 square divided by n1 plus n2 minus 2. This is for small sample we find like this. And afterwards t calculated is how do you find t here? So how is this sigma is found? Substitute these all these values n1, all those. So n1 s1 square plus n2 s2 square divided by n1 plus n2 minus 2, we get some 940 or square. This is sigma square actually. Square root of this should be taken as 40. So there is a small take here. This is sigma square. Square root of this we should take. So square root of that is 40.7.317. So now when I find t statistic, x1 bar minus x2 bar, number of hours 1234 for first company, 1036 for second company, sigma calculated just now, square root of this 40.7317, and 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2, 1 by 8 plus 1 by 7, which we get 18.148. Now I go to the n1 plus n2 minus 2 degrees of freedom, 8 plus 7 minus 2, 15 minus 2. For 13 degrees of freedom, for 95% confidence limits or 0.05 level of significance, from table if you find, you get 1.77. Just now we have seen how to find the table value. Naturally, this value is bigger than this value. Hence, 18.1 is bigger than 1.7. 18.1 is bigger than 1.7. This square root I will keep as it is for reference. Okay, just keep in mind that square root of this we should get. Now, when the hypothesis is rejected because the calculated value is greater than the table value, so we reject the hypothesis means what hypothesis we had. Type 1 is not superior to type 2. It's opposite. Reject means it's opposite. We have to say yes, type 1 is superior to type 2. So that both the companies are not same, type 1 is superior to type 2. Now, next example. Sample size of 10 and 14 were drawn. Again, see that small samples. Sample size of 10 and 14 were drawn from two populations with standard deviations for first one 3.5, for second one 5.2. The sample means were found to be 20.3 and 18.6. So sample size, standard deviations and mean, all three are given. Test whether the means of the two populations are same. That means what? There are two different companies. From one company one sample is found, and one company one more sample is found. They are asking whether the means whether the two companies, whether same, behave same. To test whether the means of the two populations, whether the means of the two companies are same or not. So we are testing already. Sometimes in examinations, these t values will be given to you. That time directly you can take this as t value, standard t value. Otherwise, the table, standard tables will be provided in the final examinations. So we note down these values, x1 bar 20.3, x1 bar 20.3, and x2 bar 18.6, x2 bar 18.6. N1 and N2 10 and 14, N1 and N2 10 and 14, and S1 and S2 sample means 3.5 and 5.2. So what we frame the hypothesis, means of two populations are same. Assume that is mean of first population mu1 equal to mean of second population mu2. Now as usual, for t distribution we find a common standard deviation by n1 s1 square plus n2 s2 square by n1 plus n2 minus 2 square root of that. So what all you have to substitute here, 10 s1 square means 3.5 square, n2 means 14, s2 means 5.2 square, divide by 10 plus 14 minus 2, square root of that, you should get 4.772. Now we shall use all this data to find t calculated. T calculated is x1 bar minus x2 bar divided by sigma square root of 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2. That I'll get 0.86. But already you are given in the question only, this is the t standard value, table value. 0.86 is smaller than 2.7 at 22 degrees of freedom. Why 22 degrees of freedom? Because n1 plus n2 is 24 minus 2. This minus 1 and this minus 1. If only one sample is there, only one's minus 1. If two samples are there, we are doing 2 times minus 1 minus, that is minus 2. So 10 plus 14, 24 minus 2 for 22 degrees of freedom. This becomes 2.07. So calculated value is 0.86, less than this. Accept the hypothesis, means of the both the populations are same. So in this, all these examples, students' redistribution, t calculated, known as t statistic or t parameter way of finding, to test whether whatever the hypothesis we are getting is rejected or accepted. So let us see. Similarly, 11 school boys were given a test in mathematics carrying maximum of 25 marks. So 25 marks test is there. So 11 school boys are giving the test. They were given extra coaching. And then again second time test is taken with the same difficulty level. The following observations were recorded. So two test marks, test 1, test 2, before coaching, after coaching. So the question is, see, the question is very practical. Does the result give evidence that the students have benefited by extra coaching? So we have to conclude whether we send tuitions and all coaching to students, whether the students are benefited or not. Technically, we can answer now. For 95% confidence limits, we are asked. Solution: students are not benefited by extra coaching. Let us assume if rejected, we have to conclude this not, we have to remove. Students are benefited. If we accept the hypothesis, students are not benefited. See here, before, after, before, after, before, after. Sometimes it is increasing, sometimes it is decreasing. Here, decreasing, increasing, 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 same, here increasing, here decreasing. So you can't conclude directly. If all are increasing, at least you can guess that it may be benefited. If all are decreasing, you can get the guess that they are not benefited. But sometimes increase, sometimes decrease, we'll have to go for the test. Now how do we go? First one, we take 23 minus 24, 20 minus 19, 21 minus 18, like that 11 times we find, for all the 11 boys we find, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. How this 1 and minus 1, minus 3 we got? 1 is 24 minus 23 is 1, 19 minus 20 is minus 1, 18 minus 21 is, that is x2 minus x1 we are doing. So that becomes a new variable only. So this we take it as difference in the test 2 marks minus difference in the test 1 marks. So once again I am telling, test 2 marks minus test 1 marks, like that 11 digits we have found, 1 minus 1 minus 3. Now this is x, suppose, then x bar is add all these and average is 1. Now what is the standard deviation of this? 1 minus x bar whole square, minus 1 minus x bar whole square, 1 minus 1 whole square, minus 1 minus 1 whole square, minus 3 minus 1 whole square, like that up to 4 minus 1 whole square. This minus 1 is common, and minus 2 minus 1 whole square divided by 11 becomes s square, and this becomes 4.4545, square root of that is 2.13. so nothing was given. We found x bar also, we find 2.13 also. So what we assume, both are same, means the difference should not we get. We should get the difference as zero. So since there is no change in the mass, we assume that mu should be zero. Actually, that is, difference should be zero actually, but difference is coming as one. So this is sample mean, this is population mean. So hence, what is the t-statistic? Sample mean 1. Since we assume that there should not be difference between first test and second test, hence average minus, so both are same average means, this is assumption, both are same average means, same average minus same average should be 0. And just now we calculated sigma 2.13, and when I substitute that, s upon square root of n minus 1, which is 1 minus 0 divided by 2.13, this should be n minus 1. We get t statistic as 1.485, and this we find for 2.23 for 10 degrees of freedom. So let us see once again the table, should not forget that table. For 11 degrees of freedom, for 95% confidence limits, some 2.90. So that example we were doing, this example for 11 degrees of freedom, so 2.23 we got actually. And hence, if this belongs to, if this modulus value is less than 2.23, or you can write this interval, that time we conclude that this value is less than this value, therefore hypothesis is accepted. On an average, students are not benefited by the extra coaching. But what we assume, let us see, students are not benefited by the extra coaching we had assumed. Since we accepted, we have to keep the conclusion same. So once again, what all we do in such type of examples, we write the data, we find some important points here, and we find t statistic, we compare with the standard table value. Either we accept it if it is less than, we reject it if it is more than. Accept it as it is straight line, as it is statement, you have to write H naught. If you reject, you have to write the opposite statement. So similarly, example 7 and example number, last example I am doing now. Suppose two horses A and B were tested according to the time in seconds to run a particular race with the following results. Test whether you can discriminate between the two horses. Discriminate means whether one horse is better than the other horse. Yes, we can discriminate between the two horses. Discriminate means two horses are different. Now horse A, okay, two horses A and B were tested according to the time in seconds to run a particular race. So first time it has run in 28 seconds. Second time it has run in 30 seconds. Third time it has run in 32 seconds. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 times you have done means 7 becomes a sample size. 7 times it has run in 28 seconds, 30 seconds. On and average means add divided by 7. Horse B was tested for 6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These many seconds it has run first time, second time 30 seconds, last time 29 seconds. So what is the question? Whether you can discriminate between the horses. How to frame the null hypothesis? No, we cannot discriminate between the horses. So if accepted, you have to write as it is. If rejected, this no, you have to remove. Now, x bar means, first x bar means what you are doing? Sum of all this divided by 7. See, sum of all this divided by 7. Sum of all this is 219 divided by 7, 31.3. Similarly, summation of y divided by n2, which is summation of all these divided by n2, summation of y divided by n2, you get 28.2. Then what is s square? How do you find s square? All x values minus 31.3 minus 31.3, that means this minus 31.3 whole square, this minus 31.3 whole square, like that, this minus 31.3 whole square, and you have to add all this. That is done, 28 minus 31.3 whole square, 30 minus 31.3 whole square, till the last one, 34 minus 31.3 whole square. And similarly, second one always minus 28.2, second one always minus 28.2, 29 minus 28.2, 30 minus 28.2, again last 29 minus 28.2. 30 minus 28.2 or 29 minus 28.2, 30 minus 28.2 last till 29 minus 28.2 whole square. add all these squares, divide by n1 plus n2 minus 2. Sample size is 7 plus 6 minus 2. So we get 5.29 and square root of that 2.306. We got s, we got x bar, we got y bar, we got n1, n2. So let us find t statistic, x bar minus y bar, common sigma, square root of 1 by n1 plus 1 by n2, 31.3, average seconds, number of seconds taken by first horse, average number of seconds taken by second horse, average common standard deviation, and this statistic we will get 2.42. But table value becomes 2.2 if you find at 11 degrees of freedom, 0.05 level of significance, 2.2 you can see the table value. So that means calculated value is greater than the table value. So rejected means we had agreed that there is a significant difference. There is no significant difference. Rejected means there is no how to remove. There is significant difference between the two horses. So my dear student friends, today we basically focused on small sample t statistic. Either one sample may be given or two samples may be given. When one sample is given, how to find t, you concentrate. When two samples are given, how to find t, you concentrate. And how to frame H0, how to accept it, how to reject it. So first, these two types of first lecture and second lecture, we concentrated on small sample, big samples. In the next lecture, there is more interesting. In the one of the modules you have learned, binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, many other distributions. Given a data, you are fitting a distribution also. Suppose you are given a frequency distribution X and F. Some of you may tell binomial is better. Some of you may tell Poisson is better. So suppose some research aspects are there. How do you tell that whatever you are fitting a curve is correct or not? That fitting of a curve, that is goodness of, what is the goodness of it? So goodness of fitting of the curve can also be tested using what is meant by CHI, chi-square distribution. More interesting. So we'll watch for that also. Till that, see you, bye, keep safe, use these slides. I'll be sending the notes in the Word format also. Make use of this. Wish you all nice time, keep safe, see you, bye.